Hey guys, today I would like to talk about my Bolani Air Fork. It has around 600 miles to date, and this is my second season riding with it.
When I first bought this fork, it was pretty much a gamble as there weren't any actual reviews to go off of. Since then, though, I have been seeing their popularity slowly creep up, but I haven't seen any first-hand accounts that speak to how durable they are. So I would like to share with you my first-hand experience with this fork. Like I said, this is my second season with the fork, and since installing it, I must have put around 600 miles on it that consist of both road and trail riding. This particular fork is a 29er straight steer tube with quick release and manual lockout. The Bolani brand sells this fork in many configurations that fit almost any style of bike, but the one thing they have in common is that they all have disc brakes, which is kind of a bummer if you have an older bike that you'd want to upgrade. You'll have to also get a new wheel and brake setup. The first thing I want to say is that this fork isn't intended for downhill or big jumps. Let's just make that clear. Bolani doesn't have any misleading advertisement of its capabilities, so there's no reason to expect these things to be a replacement for a $1,000 fork, and it's unfair to make that comparison. So who are these forks for? This fork is for an XC rider, maybe a gravel bike rider, or possibly anyone with a lower-end mountain bike that came with a coil fork. In fact, if your bike has a coil fork, then I'm willing to bet this fork might be for you. My first impression when unboxing the fork was that it seemed pretty light, but when I got my coil fork off the bike and held each fork in hand, I couldn't believe just how much lighter the Bolani fork was. I almost didn't know what to make of it, but the Bolani fork has gained my trust and has even saved my ass a couple times when I exceeded my biking capabilities. In the 2 seasons that I've had it, I've adjusted the pressure to my needs a couple of times, but the fork has never actually lost any pressure. The only maintenance I do is add a little oil to the stanchions right before a ride, cycle the fork a couple of times, and then wipe any excess oil away. As for the lockout, it ranges from very plush to completely locked out. I found it easy enough to reach down and flick the knob for whatever I'm riding on. Plus, I just think that the manual lockout keeps the cockpit clean. The only issue I've had with this fork is the 26mm bolt at the top of the stanchions have come loose. Normally, this fork works without any noise whatsoever, so it was very noticeable when the fork started making a clicking noise at the top of its travel. But the fix was simple. Just tighten the bolts back down, and the noise was gone. It's been a while, and they haven't backed out again. Though, if it does happen again, I could just add a little Loctite, and that would be a permanent solution. I really don't know what else to say about the fork. It's a noticeable upgrade from a coil fork. It does a great job of soaking up roots and rocks, and eliminates the pogo feel. Despite getting completely covered in mud multiple times, it still looks and works like new.